Today in the Care 11 Barn, we are honoring all of our members of the military. We absolutely love our members of the military. Yes, why don't we give them a round of applause? And joining me now on the Care 11 Barn stage is our friends from the Marines. A lot of times you see us work with them pretty much throughout the rest of the years with Toys for Tots, but they're always working. So we have our friend Sergeant Benjamin Zuleta, and you also brought new friends for us.
I did. I have right next to me Corporal Aspasetter and then Staff Sergeant Brown. They both work hand-in-hand with me in the office in Minneapolis, and they're also going to be working with me during the Toys for Tots season.
So let's talk a little bit about the spirit of service. I know that the Marines have a very big spirit of service. Why is that so important to you all, and why do you do it in such an intentional way?
It's super important just to stay involved with the community and making sure that we're in touch with the people that we are here to serve and protect and give back as much as we can.
We love to see that. Okay, so the Great Minnesota Get Together, as you all know, the military brings people from all over the place. None of you are from Minnesota. First timers, raise your hand. The first timers right here. Look, we got some first timers, you all, okay? And then you've been here before. What are you looking forward to the most at the state fair this year?
Me? The fried pickles.
Okay, fried pickles. I told her also about the fried ranch everybody keeps talking about. Let's talk a little bit about Toys for Tots. I know that you all work with Toys for Tots in different ways. You are leading the charge this year. You know, when it comes to Toys for Tots, what do you think people should know that they just don't realize, especially with how early you all start to work on it?
I would say it's probably, this is a full-time job. Whenever we start doing this, the amount of people that we are able to help, the amount of toys that come through, it's a full-time job. And a lot of times that means we also need your help as well. Whenever you're dropping off toys or bringing in donations, please be patient with us. We are trying our best to help everybody out that we can.
Absolutely. And you know, you all will be at Mall of America again this year. Tell us a little bit about what we can expect for this year.
Yeah, so you're going to expect a lot more involvement at the mall, just doing more events there especially. We had a great grand opening with the Toys R Us store there last year, and we're trying to just replicate all the events that we have going on there. And one thing that's amazing about Minneapolis is we're actually top 10 in the country for Toys for Tots. That's out of 750 other locations that we're at.
Give it up! Isn't that amazing? We are so excited to partner with you all. We've been partnering with you all for more than 30 years. I know that we talk about the holiday season so much, but it starts well before the holiday season. What do you want families to keep in mind when thinking about trying to give back this year?
Keeping the Christmas spirit and giving back to the kids.
Yeah, it's a big opportunity, absolutely. So I know that we've been talking a lot about different ways that you want to reach out to people. For those who want to collect, for those who are on the fence, what should they know?
We have the Toys for Tots website. If you look up Toys for Tots Minneapolis, they'll give you a link directly to our website so you can find all of our information there, how to donate, how to be a site to receive toys, my phone number there if you want to reach out to me personally. Everything's there on the website for you to reach out to.
He does answer, I can tell you that much. Why don't we give it up for our Marines today? We will be right back after this break.